Assalamualaikum and good morning to everyone. Again, we move on for next topic, topic 3A, which is engine system. So under the engine system, we are going to cover a few system that available for the mechanical engine, mainly for the tractor. First, mainly for the fuel system, intake and exhaust system, lubricating system, cooling system, reticle system, and governing system. As for the learning outcome for this topic, you should be able to understand different transmission. This is also a part of the power transmission system that we are going to cover a little bit. And should be able to comprehend some of the system and also principle of moving the speed and torque, the variation of the gear setting. Alright, for the fuel system, a fuel system is the function to deliver the clean fuel required quantity. So just like our daily life, you need to have a very good clean water. So that's for the engine. So we need to have a good quality fuel, and normally the fuel will be stored in the safe fuel storage and normally fuel tank that's next to the engine components. And there are three main fuel systems, namely gasoline, diesel, and LPG gas, which is the last one, the later one, which is not going to cover much in this topics, but just a snapshot, because some of the tractor also operates based on the LPG gas, which is a lot more cheaper than both on the two top two. Alright, on the fuel system, which is, for example, here the gasoline system, first of all, you have, of course, a fuel tank from the figure. You can see from fuel tank, every fuel tank, you should have a fuel pump and then fuel filters, and then go for the engine, which is for the carburetor mixture and the combustion, and with the help of a intake. And the fuel system should be able to supply the combustible mixture, which is the fuel and air. And you should have also should be able to find the main components of the fuel system, which is consists of fuel tank, pump, and carburetor for the gas leak. However, for the diesel engine is slightly different. So like we already discussed before, there is no spark plug on the diesel engine, but instead of carburetor, also there is they will use a fuel injection pump and spray. So from here, the system pretty much replicates what you have on the gasoline. However, there is recover oil, recover diesel and diesel oil excess, go back to the fuel tank. It's like a closed loop system rather than a one-way loop system. Alright. LPG gas system similar, however, it's a closed system. Normally the fuel is mixed with the air at low temperature with high pressure for the combustion. And the fuel tank normally close to the unit to prevent the vapor. And also because of the LPG gas, it still require a carburetor for the mixing of the fuel and the air. Alright, in terms of the safety, the big safety on the safety concern of the fuel system, so we shouldn't be refuel the fuel inside the tractor during its hot operation, so it's become dangerous and flammable for the fuel. Alright, next the system that we are going to discuss is intake and exhaust system. So the intake is mainly for the air and also for the fuel, and also the exhaust system for after the combustion. So this both system is very important to in order to help in filling up the gap of the combustion system. So intake system will carry the fuel and air mixture into the engine and remove exhaust gas after combustion, and normally will take up from the clean air filter and then go inside the engine to the manifold and etc. And after combustion, you have very bad air quality, which is need to take out from the exhaust to muffler. And the exhaust system normally is consists of three main parts: exhaust valve, manifold, and muffler, which is will be on different function. Alright, next is lubricating system, which is the oil for the lubrication parts. So we need to reduce the friction as well as to dissipate heat of the engine parts, and also for the doing the cleanings. And the engine oil is the lubricating oil is different it has some rating based on American standards. So we are going to discuss this later. But here, some of the oil lubricating system is delivered to the pumping of the regulated valve, and also to the components of the mechanical components of the engine. So this is very important in helping the engine for the smooth operation. Alright, next is a cooling system. So I believe some of the operation, some of the basic stuff already covered in the practical exercise. So I'm going to give you some of the only for the snapshot. So here is a cooling system with the help of the hot water or some liquid coolant, as well as with the help for the airflow. So here you can see that on the top there is a hot water, hot liquid will flow from the top, and then from the different temperature radiant pressure, so then the water will be able to flow to the pump, as well as because of the nature of the cold and heat temperature differences. So from here you can see there is a water pump, coolant, engine, water jacket, thermostat, which is controlled as the at certain temperature there will be only fan will be triggered at certain temperature. When we say hot on the engine, there is a requirement for the engine to operate, which is at the ideal engine temperature, so which is very important for the engine to warming up during before operation. Okay, and next is the electrical system. So charging unit, if you have the battery on the car, so normally is only the system electrical system that help to crank the flywheel. So with the help of starter, motor starter, so the flywheel should be able to rotate, and from here you'll be able to rotate the piston, and from the piston and you will ignite, compress the fuel, and also ignite the doing the ignition and then the power. So same thing work for the gasoline and also for the diesel engine. So this is very basic information. So from here is kind of general flow. So you have a battery which is going to supply the power for the motor to rotate, and we'll crank the flywheel, and we'll crank the flyshaft to the rotation of the flywheel. So the starter switch is only to supply the current to the motor switch, so which is going to rotate the motor. So don't get confused. So if I ask you, so what make the engine what start from the electrical system? So the answer should be starting motor. Okay. And next is the ignition circuit. Since we have four cylinders, so always remember the magic numbers. Excuse me. So magic numbers is always there is two numbers at the end of each magic numbers, 1 and 2, and then in the middle between 4 and 3. So you can replicate the combustion, the magic number is reflect to the combustion sequences in producing the power, which is controlled by the distributor of the electrical charge. Right, and lastly is governing system is very important in terms of governing the engine power, especially when the engine of the tractor carries the heavy load. So the governing system is only available on the tractor by mechanical means. And nowadays, if you have the modern tractor is already controlled by CPU. of the tractor, the control computer units of the tractor to govern the mixture of the fuel and air mixture, but not on the tractor, which is on the diesel engine, the mixture of the fuel, which is never happened, which is you should be remember that. But instead of fuel air mixture, only the gas, only the diesel will be burned, which is a lot in terms of to overcome the loads. Right, some regular maintenance for the fuel, some of the fluid for the engine change for tractor is about 40 to 50 hours of operation. So remember that for the tractor, we didn't count for the mileage, we count for the hours of operations. So some other type of engine oil instead of same for the your car, so 50 W40 and etc. Those follow some of the standard developed by the country. And the filters for the engine oil, hydraulic oil, and air filter, which is normally done with the spec from the manufacturer. Right, this is the internal part of the filters. So take a look and try to read some of the information. So the end of the slides. So name five of the seat engine system. So very easy, we have that answer. And D, what atomize and mix the fuel with air to provide the combustible mixture of the engine. So this is mainly for the gasoline engine. So the answer is the carburetor. And what system take control of the entire engine processes, especially during heavy load operation? So it should be governance system. So with that, thank you very much.